Captain Falcon! 3, 2, 1, go! Thank you.
everything. Even money spent on used, scratched up gear and cheap microphones and cheap headphones.
These don't look cheap to me, dude.
That's the point.
Should I be talking this close?
You should be talking right into the mic.
Right here. Oh, there we go.
Yeah. If you want, you can turn down a little bit. All right.
So I've kind of been watching, but this is... The games are 1-1, and it looks really easy.
Hit him. Okay. Oh, good trade. Good trade. You went now. See if I, you have to come. You have to play next time, dude. What? Yeah. And then get 3-0'd by Justin. That's the story of my life. All right. Get good. Oh, look at that one. He just scooped him. Okay. So... Balloon is at such a high percent trying to avoid those back air scoops. But he's got a chance. He only needs one good grab and open up. That's it. Done. 2-1. Can feel my $5 creeping away from me.
Boy.
I don't want him to go. All right. And so they go right back to it. This is probably a good choice for Justin.
Yeah?
Yeah, he doesn't have FD, so...
Yeah, I guess this is the next best thing.
Yeah. He did have a pretty good set against him on Green Hill Zone. I didn't know if that was the one that he won. I haven't been paying attention, unfortunately. But he's doing good. He just needs to avoid getting grabbed. That's probably been his like biggest downfall. Bard has been converting a lot of his grabs into very definitive classic Falcon strings into, you know, ABC 1-2-knee. Mm-hmm. So, and Bard for his part has been trying to mix it up and do exactly that. Use the speed of Falcon to he's in his head, dude. He's in his head.
Dude, that's... I don't even know if that's read. I think that might be a reaction, dude.
You think?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, even if it is, like, props to Bart. He's been putting it in. Okay.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, see, Justin's just not doing a good job. He's got the aerials, but he's not stuffing in Captain Falcon's approaches. He's mostly just fiddling. Fiddling ain't enough sometimes. All right, 72.
Yeah, honestly, ooh. I'm not sure about the stage choice. Even if it were FD, like, I realize FD is good for Mewtwo because he can, like, wall people out, and Justin was doing that and is making use of that. But, like, I think Bard's a good enough Falcon where you need to, like, trap his neutral game somehow, and there's nowhere to trap Captain Falcon on a stage like this, especially one like Bart who knows exactly what he's doing at all times.
Yeah, it's just too hard, you know? Justin's kind of doing what he needs to, though. Back airs and taking advantage of the open-ups. The platform, though, has definitely not been helping him out. I think he would much prefer it not be there.
He's been doing that on purpose, just the release.
I think so. Because it's interesting, right? It's a mix-up.
I guess. But it's like, even if you can't get a follow-up off of a throw, at least a throw will be doing damage.
That's true.
And he's not like getting a follow-up after not doing a throw, so might as well do it.
Okay. Dustin's, he's got those, though. This will be another one, and that'll be it. Yeah. So he's taking it back pretty slowly. He's going to need a good string and to avoid this. But... Oh, okay. Bang, bang. Goes the... Oh, yeah. So that's what he needed. And now Justin needs to take this to the bank. So even, doable for either player. Well, rip my $5.
Oh, that was the set, wasn't it?
Yep. Bart's staring at me. He's like, this is what you get for not believing. This is your punishment. He doesn't even care, dude.
I don't know, dude. You have to not believe in somebody.
Sam smirking over there. I don't like that, dude. I don't want Sam to be happy for my ignorance.
Oh, dude, this song sounds so good with the headphones on, actually.
Yeah, it does. It's pretty cool.
Man.
All right, 0-0 back to Battlefield. We'll see what Justin can do here. Now, I made the call earlier that is interesting, that I think Bart will win now, just because he's gotten Justin's head, and he's Justin downloads, but I think Bart downloads better, and Justin's style is good, but it relies on the same stuff pretty heavily. So we'll see if he's able to throw in any mix-ups to make it more interesting, just not even make it more interesting, just to make it a little tougher for Bart to know what to do and how to approach. Back here. Another back air. And another back air. And another back air. And Justin has a favorite move, if you didn't notice.
Well, for a reason. There's the reason. Man, I could never play Falcon, dude. I just don't know how he's, like, expected to, like, stay away in the neutral and then get in on something.
It's hard.
It's really hard.
What?
We're just being quiet. Well, at the very least, I found that $5 on the street, so...
You found $5 on the street?
I did find $5 on the street. You know how that's, like, the meme story ender?
Yeah.
To, like, a boring story, and then I found $5? I actually found $5, except there wasn't, like, a boring story to it. I just found $5.
That was just the beginning and the end of the story.
Yeah. I, like, held it up in front of myself and, like, looked around just in case there was anyone, like, looking around at their pockets or just kind of standing around, and there was nobody on the whole block, so I was like... Sweet.
Yeah, dude.
Someone else has lost, which I feel bad for, but found $5.
Dude, there's going to be, like, some article in the, like, school newspaper.
Oh, we take
We
those?
Left $5 on the ground just to see who's the scumbag who just picked
I
it up.
I am that asshole.
No, dude.
Yeah.
There's nothing scumbaggy if there's no one there to receive it.
Yeah. You ever get that, like, psych question, like, what is the amount of money at which you would, like, not just keep it and you would instead just, like...
Oh, and just leave it there.
Yeah. Like, what is your amount, you know?
I don't know. It's less than a dollar.
Is it?
If there was a dollar on the ground, I would pick it up.
No. Not just leave it. The amount more than that. I found $5 on the street. I looked around. There was nobody there. I wanted $5, so I kept $5. How much would have to be there such that I, like, went to the authorities or something? Like, how much would it take, you know?
Yeah.
And I don't know. I think when I had to answer the site question, I was like $100. Like, if I found just a 50 on the ground, I'd probably be just like, eh. I don't know. You'd Everyone's like, got to have some amount,
it's
right?
It's now immoral to take this, is what you're saying.
Yeah, like, you know, it's hard to say. Like, it has the same effect, right? Someone still lost that money. You didn't do anything decent to earn it. It's just, you just got it now because you're walking around or whatever.
Okay, so if you saw 40 bucks, you wouldn't
see,
leave that.
That's like just
that's the whole problem, I guess, is the gray area.
Yeah, there's like there ever and the point of the psychological experiment is not to find out how much money. It is to emphasize that everybody, whether we like it or not, has some amount, you know.
Right.
Like,
right.
There is an amount at which you would, like, call the cops, like, hey, I found a ridiculous amount of money on the street.
Yeah.
That amount exists. You know, that was the point of the psych experiment. Or maybe it was a social experiment. I don't remember. In some class I had to take a long time ago. But that was the basic point of it. Like, we all have a number, whether we want to admit it or not.
I don't see why anyone wouldn't want to admit it.
Yeah, well, it's like, because then you imagine to yourself that you're being just as terrible if it's $5 as if it's 20, right?
Right.
And that somehow you're justifying someone else's loss of $5 to yourself because it's just $5, you know?
Yeah, I see what you're saying.
And I had like a dark GTF for this, right? Who was just like, that $5 could have been someone's last sandwich on Earth. And I was like,
how dare
yeah.
you?
Yeah.
It's like, then why did they leave it on the ground? How did that end up happening?
Who knows, dude?
Who says to themselves, all right, I only have $20 left to live on. That should last me 1 week if I really stretch it. And then they're like, I'll just leave it here.
Yeah.
I'll be back.
It was pretty clearly dropped, though. It was like just kind of off to the side and like folded up as if it had like kind of crunched out of someone's pocket.
Yeah.
Rip that poor soul. It went to gambling.
Oh, did you see that graph?
I did see that graph.
That's weird. Dude, neutral air is everything.
Ooh.
For Falcon.
Yeesh. We saw a couple of those. Bart likes, that's one of his favorite pressures, is just dash dance a lot. In place to screw with the person you're pushing towards the ledge.
Yeah, but is that pressure or is that being evasive? Because those are opposite things.
I don't know. I think it can be seen as pressure. Falcon's fast enough
for sure.
That if you don't know where he's going or what he's doing, you're more than likely to get forced into some kind of, if not bad option, at least a predictable one.
I guess that's true, yeah.
Like dash attack, I think, is what Daniel tried out of it, and he had a knee ready to hit that before the hitbox even came out.
Yeah.
It's in the giphy.
Honestly, I've been, like, trying to focus on dash dancing well recently. Like obviously, I can do it. It's just a matter of doing it in the right places and for the right reasons. And I feel like my entire, like, Smash career, I guess. Like, I've just been not using it that well.
Yeah, I would agree with that. But I play Sheik, so... The lack thereof is noticeably impedient. Impedient?
Yeah, it's almost asking for trouble if a Sheik starts dash dancing, I'm sure.
It's like, oh, you think you're a decent character, you. Oh,
Sheik's
you.
Sheik's a decent character?
In this game? No.
Oh, maybe not in this game. That's true.
Oh, well, a little bit more so now that she's... They did some funny stuff to her. But now she's basically Sheik for Melee. But there's a lot of characters that in this game that still do better against Sheik for Melee.
Yeah. It's just this game is just a different, like, world, dude.
I hear ya. 62. Like, shout out to Gimpy Fish, wherever you are in the world.
Like, as soon as I went off Jigglypuff for PM, like, that was the reason, was because I realized, okay, the reason Jigglypuff was so good in Melee was because she could take advantage of the little nitty-gritty things that Melee's all about. And PM, it's like, people have so many broad options that Jigglypuff just can't do anything.
Lucario! Dude, Brandon, this is your fight!
Dude, the permission to play me. Not really.
He's just charging Spirit Auras. or RS spheres.
Oh, dude. Is he? No, okay.
You got to do it, because otherwise it'll do it like 20 times in a row afterwards.
May as well be a four stock, dude. Where do you tell how many people are watching?
There are three people watching. I'm pretty sure it's basically Brendan. I think it's just actually Brendan and nobody else.
Liquid brick.
Liquid brick.
Wait, that was 1-1, right? Or is that 1-2?
I don't know.
Who would counterpick here?
They'll know when they're done.
Yeah, they'll know. I believe them. Wait, no. Brendan, hit us up with that information that I should probably have. Who won? I have a replay. I'm still too far back in time. I'm so tired, dude.
Yeah.
I want to go to like sleep for a million years, except actually only 2 days because I have a final on Monday at 10.
No, you want to sleep through the final. You just don't want the consequences.
No, yeah. Fine. That's life, ain't it? I want all these things, but I just don't want the consequences of them.
Yeah.
You see, there is only one truth, causality. Call and defend. I need to go watch that movie again.
What movie is that?
That was from the second Matrix movie.
Oh, I need to watch that.
Yeah, and people shit on the second one all the time, and it makes me mad just because, like, I like the second one. It had a lot. It took the whole, like, it introduced the Matrix metagame, dude. Because, like, the first one, as cool as it was, you could see what was happening to Neo. You could tell, like, okay, Neo's gonna, like, be Jesus, and he's, like, gonna defeat the guys, and it's good, and he's, like, gonna go fly, and that's cool. Like,
yeah,
the Matrix 2 made you question, like, everything about that, you know?
Like, in the first one? Or in the second one?
Yeah, the second one. It made you, like, wonder what was going on, and if you actually understood the plot of the movie.
Yeah, all I know about everything after one, number one of the Matrix is, like, seriously, like, my second favorite movie.
Yeah, it's so,
like,
good, dude.
It's way up there. Like, I think it's, like, saying stuff, you know? But, I haven't seen the second and third ones, but the third one I saw like a little clip of, like while it was on TV, and it's just like this war that's going on. I'm like, this doesn't mean anything anymore. No.
Yeah, the third one was, honestly, the third one could have been compressed into the second one. It could have just been two.
Yeah.
It just kind of made like a long dramatic battle. Like, that was kind of like their prerogative, I guess, but it was still pretty annoying. All right. So
well, look at this guy saying, damn, a Mewtwo made it to Grand Finals.
A 3.6 Mewtwo made it to Grand Finals.
Well, who started the rumor that Mewtwo is now bad? Because that is not true.
I think Justin to play with people's minds. Okay.
Oh, I thought it was like a broader thing, like the world at
it
large suddenly
is.
Decided
probably
Mewtwo
is.
Isn't good. But then again, I have no idea what the world at large has ever said about anything in PM.
Yep. Nor will we ever know anymore.
Yep. We are only local now. Oh. Have I told you my sad story about this stage?
Tell me your sad story about this stage.
So, when I got the Wii, like, a lot of it was so I could, like, practice Project M and stuff, and, like, the first thing I did was put, like, custom music on it.
Yeah.
And that was the one where they just came out with, I guess it must have been, like, 3.52 or, you know, something like that. Like, it was the one where They had the original WarioWare stage, but instead of the pig, like, they suddenly had, like, Ashley's face, I think. And Ashley looks just like Miku in that thing, so I put a Miku song on this stage and it worked perfectly, and everything was, like, atmospheric and stuff. And then I had to download this, and it's like, oh, now it's, like, this Wario thing with weird music. So, like, first day already ruined.
Kind of like Justin's getting pretty well ruined here. I guess Justin's winning.
Yeah, he's winning, dude. You can't call that guess.
Yeah, I opened my eyes and guessed. Because now I want Justin to lose because he let a bracket reset happen and cost me $5. Yeah.
Dude, this is really a true sign of, like, skill, though, to be able to, like, to have a match where you're both punishing each other, like, as hard as you could possibly punish, like, not dropping the edge guards whatsoever.
It's,
like,
nice. It's fun.
And, like, it's staying even. Like, that's real skill, dude.
Here I was saying we were going to get out of here by 11.
Who was saying that? Oh, okay.
My boo.
What about Melee?
Like I said, here I was saying we were going to get out of here by 11.
Oh, okay. I heard you wrong, I think.
Yeah, I was being sarcastic. Like, rip. Knee?
Knee!
Oh, sorry. But actually a knee this time would probably finish it off. Up throw into stomp into shielded knee, but then into another shield attack, and an up tilt will finish it off pretty cleanly. They seem pretty happy about that. It was pretty interesting there near the end. Dustin had some pretty good options, but then, and then it was a humble ending after all things.
What?
Sitting up on the edge.
I think so.
And an up tilt will seal it off. All right. So we're going to take a minute here.